Okay, let's start with word of prayer. Let's pray. God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving one more day to live for your glory. Lord, we thank you. And we have been learning your word from last Sunday. And Lord, you have been guiding us, so Lord, we thank you. And thank you for your guidance and your protection. Lord, we thank you. And we will continue to learn today. Lord, we need your wisdom and your knowledge so that we can understand. Lord, there are many things that is hidden. Unless you reveal us, we cannot understand. So Lord, we pray, please open our heart and mind so that we can understand. And Lord, we thank you once again for this time. And Lord, continue to bless each one of us. And in Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Okay, we'll continue. Good evening to you all once again. And as we could not finish this number three, how do I know the Bible is true? So today, I will continue with that. Through the history and the fulfillment of the prophecy, we can know that the Bible is true. Without evidence, actually, we cannot just believe and we cannot just take it. Now, this is the age of science, so everyone wants to, everyone's to see the evidence. Everyone wants to see the evidence, so we will see through the evidence whether the Bible is true or not, through the historical evidence. Okay, I will read first this one, Isaiah 41 verse 21 to 22. Let me read. Present your case, says the Lord. Bring forth your strong reasons, says the King of Jacob. Let them bring forth and show us what will happen. Let them show the former things what they were, that we may consider them and know the latter end of them, or declare to us things to come. So the things that are to come hereafter, that we may know that you are gods, yes, do good or do evil, that we may be dismayed and see it together. So here again, yesterday also, we have seen this scripture. Let me explain again. This is the conversation between Israelites and God, we can say. So God is saying to Israelites, says the King of Jacob. You see here, it's King of Jacob. So God is saying to Israelites, bring forth your strong reason. Let them bring forth and so the things what happen and what will happen in the future, then if they can eat that God which you worship, you turn away from me and you are worshiping that God, if they can sow really, then you can worship really through God. But if they cannot sow what happened, they cannot tell what happened, then you are worshiping that is not through God. And today, we'll think about this. Biblical history and evidence. Bible, we see in the Bible, God doesn't want us just to believe in Him without knowing anything. So God revealed many things in the Bible. So we see the story, first civilization, human civilization, Garden of Eden. So whether it is true or not, we need to find out. So without evidence, we cannot really say that is from God. So Garden of Eden, and whether there's a proof or not, we will see. And Noah's flood, Sodom and Gomorrah, Tower of Babel, the Red Sea crossing. These are the major story we see in the Bible. So whether it is true or not, if these are not true, then we cannot take the Bible as the word of God. So let's see whether there is evidence or not. First, we'll go for the Garden of Eden. You may have heard many times, actually this is the first thing we see in the Bible, when you read the Bible, the story about human beings. And from here, the human civilization have started. And the first man, Adam and Eve, came out from the garden. And God put them in the garden, and later they didn't obey the word of God, so they are thrown from this garden. That's what we see in the Bible. So, whether the question is now, you can think of this. Was it true? If it is the true, then where was it located? There must be some evidence if it is true. And what happened to it? If that is true, then what happened to it now? And also, if it is true, is there any proof of its existence? So these are basic questions we can think about the Garden of Eden. Okay, let's think one by one. The Bible introduces about the Garden of Eden in Genesis chapter 2, verse 10 to 12. Let me read. Now a river went out of Eden to water the garden, and from there it parted and became four river heads. The name of the first is Pishon. It is the one which guards the whole land of Havilah, where there is gold, and the gold of that land is good. Bdellium and the onyx stone are there. So we can see here, from that garden, Eden Garden, the four river departed from each other. That's what here we see. So first name, the name of the river is given here, Pishon. Okay, let's follow what the other names. The name of the second river is Gihon. It is the one which goes around the whole land of Cush. The name of the third river is Herikal. It is the one which goes toward the east of Assyria. The fourth river is the Euphrates. And the Herikal name in NIV you'll find Tigris. So we can see here four rivers mentioned in the Bible in the second chapter of the first book, Genesis. And this scripture said these four rivers departed from Eden Garden. So this river can give us the clue of Eden Garden. Now, where is that river? What happened to that river? Let's find out. Let's see first the world map, where the garden, Eden Garden, is located. We can see my left hand side is America flag, and we can see Indian flag. We all know, most of us Indian, so we know Indian flag. And now, where is that Eden Garden? Oh, this is South Korea flag. And you see the middle there's a circle with red color, and there is Eden Garden. How do I know? Because which we read in the scripture, the Bible, four rivers names are mentioned, is still flowing in that area. And there is Israel. Israel also located in the middle. Okay. Now, this Tigris, which we read in the Genesis chapter 2, the Tigris or Helical, still the river exists even today. And also another river, Euphrates, it's also today is existed. Today it exists. So, but the thing is, another two rivers are missing now. So, archaeologists, the scholar, if really there is Bible is true, then there must be other two rivers also. If that is not, then the Bible is false. So, in 1981. With the 1981 or 82, I'm not very sure, 82, I think. Yes, 82, 1982. So Central Columbia took the picture with a satellite, and that area is now desert. So inside the sand, below 6 meter, they found, of course, they took the picture many areas, but they found nearby that areas like a river fossils, and conclude that are the missing river. And you can also, if you have time, you can Google, you can watch in YouTube, Dr. Jaran, he explained about that. Okay. His professor. Yeah, so this is the fossil river found by the satellite. And this black part is indicate the fossil river, and red part indicate the sand. So it's below 6 meter. Another are below 6 meter. And it's measured like as large as Nile rivers, this area. Okay, not only that, and there are, after archaeologists, they found many sculpture or many painting in the cave, on the stone, so they found. But now, at present, no one is living there. So all this indicate that when that area was populated area. And this all shows that the Eden Garden is true. And not only that, yeah, this kind of sculpture they found. And also, the Bible said, now what happened, if really that is true, then what happened now? Bible has the answer, Ezekiel chapter 31, verse 18, prophet Ezekiel said about that. Let me read. Which of the trees of the Eden can be compared with you in splendor and majesty? Yet you too will be brought down with the trees of Eden to the earth below. This is talking to the Egyptian, that you will bring down like an Eden garden, like an God brought down the trees and plants of Eden. So same thing will happen to you. So that's what God said to the Egypt, because that time Egypt was the strongest. So God is saying that Eden garden was brought down under the earth, below the earth. And what is the evidence that the garden, Eden garden, goes below or under the ground? What is the evidence? What is the proof? The proof is, now, you know, according to the Bible, it says all this animal, plant, all this goes down under the earth and covered. Now, the proof is which we are using crude oil, petroleum. You know, Middle East country, they are supplying more than 70% of the world, they are supplying petrol. We get from them all their capture. 70% they are supplying all over the world. So now, when we think, now in our time, we can find that Middle East countries are the desert area, almost all part of Middle East country. But now, science says how crude or petroleum produce. If the trees, plants, animals, it goes under the earth, and after a long time, it can produce petroleum. So now, that gives us the proof that there was the Eden Garden was there. Otherwise, from where they get the petroleum, right? Okay, now we'll go to next topic. Now there are so many petroleum company in Middle East country, we know. Now let's talk about the Noah's Ark. Noah's Ark also, there are many questions people arise, like how it can happen all the world, how it can be under the water. Now these days we know there are Himalayan mountains, so high mountains, how it can be possible? So many people, they say, no, that's why I cannot believe the Bible. But let's see, it possible or not, whether we have evidence or not. So many people say this is the story, not really true. Okay. As Adam and Eve are cast out from Eden Garden because they disobey God and they are increasing and they forget God again. They're supposed to worship God, but no one is worshiping God. They're supposed to obey God, but all people forget. So, Bible say, I'm sorry that I made human beings because they are all turned away from God. So, God asks Noah, because only Noah was searching God in his generation. So God asks Noah, build an ark. Because I'm going to destroy all these people of the world. So Noah believed God's word. So he started working on making the ark. That's the story. Okay, we'll see. And Genesis chapter 6 talk about that. Let me read verse 5. Then the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. So what this is what God said in red part. Every intent of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. That's what the Bible said. Now people cannot think good things. Only what they can think is evil, and their heart is fully evil, and that continue. So that's what happened in the time of Noah. And Noah, only Noah, was seeking God from the heart. But other people, all are turned away from God, and they only know how to do sin. Genesis chapter 6, verse 13. And God said to Noah, the end of all flesh has come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. So now, all what they can do is evil, and the earth, the whole people become violence. They kill each other, they hate each other. I think if we compare, our time is also same. So that's why we can also say that Jesus coming is very near, because Jesus already promised that he will destroy this earth also with the fire, but not with the water anymore, but with the fire. So God said, Noah, I'm going to destroy. Now, in order to save yourself, build an ark. Verse 14 to 15. Let me read. Verse 14 to 15. Make yourself an ark of gopher wood. Make rooms in the ark and cover it inside and outside with a pitch. And this is how you shall make it. The length of the ark shall be 300 cubits, its width 50 cubits, and its height 30 cubits. So length is how much? 135 meter if we convert into meter. And the width, if we convert into meter, 23 meter about approximately. And the height is approximately 14 meter. So 135 meter, if some expert after calculating give the measurement, that it's like a football stadium, international football stadium, with that, and this is, that is also third room, third floor, first, second, third. So that's the Noah's ark, and this measurement is given by God. So God said to Noah, build in such way. And now, you know, even the biggest ship was built in with this ratio, and that's why Titanic, they say it cannot be seen anymore, so they are very proud. But we see that the Titanic was broken and it was sink. And experts say this ratio, if the ship can be made with this ratio, it's very stable. Very stable. Okay, anyway, this is the ark which Noah built. And Genesis chapter 7. What happened in Genesis chapter 7? It started raining, and all the earth becomes under the water. Let me read. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, the 17th day of the month, on that day, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of heaven were open, and the rain was on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. You see here, very precisely is given, in the 600th year of Noah's. So some of you may be wondering, how Noah, 600 men can live 600 years? In the Bible we see, Hebrews, men live 900 years before Noah, before Noah's flood. So in the second month, it was started raining, 17th day of the month, it's precisely even. And also, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up. Fountains, that means from earth, broken out, and it water comes. And also, and the windows of heaven were opened. What is the windows of heaven? I will explain later. And the rain was on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. Continuously raining 40 days and 40 nights. That's what happened, the Bible says. So, here, the fountains of the great deep were broken up. So from the fountain, I think we all know, just it comes from the earth, water comes out. And like this. And also, from the windows of heaven were open. What is that? You know, before Noah's flood, the earth was like this. It looks like this. We can see the thick water layer, or we can also say ozone layer, which protect the earth from the harmful rays. So from the sun, the harmful rays cannot enter into the earth because of this water layer. But now present earth condition is like this. The water layer is completely gone. Little bit it remains. Ozone layer is very thin now. So that's why you know, the always if we see, we open the news, we can hear global warming and all this. Why this happening? Why climate are changing? Not like before, where sometimes it's very cold and extreme cold, and some places extreme hot. Not, but before Noah's flood, the climate on this earth was perfect. So that's why animals, trees, plant, man can live long, and also the size also bigger than today's. Again, so water layer is no more now. And even Bible talk about that. When God, in Genesis, you'll see God say that God made water above the firmament and also below the firmament. That's what we see in the Bible. And chapter 7 verse 12, it says the rain was on the earth 40 days and 40 nights, continuously 40 days and 40 nights. And all the earth are under the water. Now, from where the water comes? We found, Bible said, all the waters which was protecting the earth all came down, and from the fountain it comes, and also it rains. So that's how water comes. Now another question can be, many people ask, many people think, and like this: if that is true, then where all the water has gone now? It is also, we have to think. What happened? The Bible, again, according to the Bible, what does it say? Let me read. He gathers the waters of the sea together as a heap, he lays up the deep in storehouse. So we see the two things. One, he gathered together as a heap, and also he lays up the deep storehouses. So he put on the storehouse, God put the water on the storehouse, and also another thing is he made as a heap, he kept. So now, how the water can be kept as heap? It's God is saying that, we can see here, that all the waters, he sent his breath, then all water becomes ice. And now you see, in this world, North Pole and South Pole, how many ice, how thick the iceberg is, so huge. We can say ice mountain, right? So we see that God said God keep as a heap, and that means God made the water an ice. And now, what happened to the ark? Let me read. The water receded steadily from the ark. At the end of the 150 days, the water had gone down, and on the 17th day of the 7th month, the ark came to rest on the mountains of Ararat. Now, where the ark is gone? If the ark is true, then where is the ark? I will say, the ark rested on Mount Ararat. After the water comes down, water dried up, and the ark was rested on Mount Ararat. So with the water, it flowed here and there, and at last it rest on Mount Ararat. So now, where is Mount Ararat? If we see the map indicate us that where is Mount Ararat. It is eastern Turkey. Okay, this is the Mount Ararat, and there are so many mountains in Ararat. But one of the Bible said one of the mountains of Ararat, the ark has rested. Okay, and this Mount Ararat is a very high, more than 5,000 meter from the sea level, about 5,000 meter. So almost whole year cover, the half of the mountain is covered by the snow. So the ark still protected now, and many people go and see that mountain, that ark. So first man who went and see is a man who climbed the Mount Everest or mountain. He's Navarra from France, but he climbed with his son, but they couldn't enter. So just they bring some of the woods from outside, the chalk, which are visible. Almost all the years, this ark is not visible because of the snow. But only some few months or few days is visible. That also not full. Some part, different time. Another part, it's like that. So you see here little bit. You can see, so little bit visible, and with a high range camera, you can see zoom. Yeah, this one. Okay, So yeah, from far, this one. And this man taking some picture. And also, yeah, Sierra Navarra is a Frenchman. He brought some of the woods in 1950s, and he sent different three laboratories which he brought the wood, and the wood laboratory report says that the wood which Bible mentioned is the same wood, and this wood is also the age is very old, like 5,000 years old, something like that the laboratory reported. So what the Bible mentioned is exactly correct. And also in 2010, Hong Kong, some evangelist group with some from the Turkey, they about 15 people, they climb up on the mountain, and they enter even they could enter the ark, inside the ark, and they found some of the case which the food given to the animal, so that kind of case they found and they bring and they keep in the museum, and they make a news conference. So this is the picture of new conference. So there are so many evidence about the Noah's Ark. You see here, have Hong Kong evangelists found the biblical Noah's Ark? This is the newspaper which they give the to the news conference. I have a video also, but I could. It's difficult to play video, so I won't be playing. Okay, you can search in YouTube. You can find. I don't know whether it's there or not, but it might be there. Okay, let's go to another. Another story, we found Sodom and Gomorrah. Genesis 18:20. Let me read. And the Lord said, because the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very great. So, those who read the Bible, you may know about Sodom and Gomorrah. Actually, many people talk about the Sodom and Gomorrah. And many people don't believe this also. But this is also a fact. So why Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed? Because of the moral sin. Right? So what happened? Let me read. And the Lord said, okay, same verse. Then the Lord rained brimstone and fire on Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord out the heavens. So he overthrew those cities, all the plain, all the inhabitants of the cities, and what grew on the ground. So the sin was so great, that's why God destroyed the Sodom and Gomorrah, and also some cities nearby, they are also destroyed. With what? Brimstone. Brimstone and fire. What is brimstone? Brimstone is actually a fire which comes through the stone. So this is the brimstone, and many people don't believe. This is also they say. Some people say this is just story. You know, number one, what we have to know from the Sodom and Gomorrah is, in 1929, William Albright found that Sodom was in the southern area of the Dead Sea. So even the location is found, the remaining. And second, in 1967, Paul Lapp, L-A-P-P, their team began to start excavating the area. Okay, that area. Number three, in 1989, one Greek archaeologist, Thomas Scope, found the city Jor. This is another city, because some cities are also destroyed along with Sodom and Gomorrah. And he also found the remains of second city. He named this city Numeira. And another thing is 99% purity brimstone, and brimstones are found on that area. Brimstone. Okay, I'll show you the picture. These are the after the excavation, they found some houses and all this naked, hugging each other, all this kind of, even the picture. Picture means like they draw on the stone, they carve on the stone, that kind of things. And yeah, this is the brimstone. You see, brimstone. So after they collect all this brimstone, actually this is the thick ash because all the cities was burned. And they found inside the earth and collect many, and after burning, easily can burn this stone. So God destroyed the Sodom and Gomorrah with the brimstone, and that is fact and that is true. And this is the area. Yeah, now full is covered by A. Yes. Genesis chapter 11 verse 1. And this is another story. Now the whole earth had one language and one speech. Before there was only one language. But because of the sin, God made confusion. So from that time, many languages come up. Now India has more than 2,000. I think only Northeast itself more than 2,000. Northeast India itself. So whole India, I don't know how many languages are there. Anyway, whole world, how many languages we can find. But there was one language. That's what the Bible said. And what happened? The language, it's spread, I mean, it's the language becomes many from the Babel Tower. Okay, let's see. This is Babel Tower. And what happened Babel Tower? Actually, after Noah's flood, God said to Noah, go, scatter, be fruitful, and multiply, and fill the earth. But what happened? They all live together. Why they live together? Because when we live together, it is comfortable and it's protect, can protect, and also you know, all things can be convenient. If you scatter, wild animals can attack easily, or other people can easily attack you. So that's the reason they stay together. So they didn't go. They built, and they say, what they say? They say, now let's build so that we can glorify our name. They're supposed to glorify God's name, but they glorify themselves. So that's why God confused their language. Let me read. Genesis chapter 11 verse 4. And they said, come, let us build ourselves a city, and a tower whose top is in the heavens. Let us make a name for ourselves, lest we be scattered abroad over the face of the whole earth. So here on the line part, you see, let us make a name for ourselves. Let us make name for ourselves. So they didn't obey God. They're supposed to scatter and live and fulfill God's commandment. They should fill the earth. But they didn't do that. So that's against God, and that is sin before God. So that's why God destroyed. So Ham, Sam, Japheth, the descendant of Ham, I mean Noah's, it's believed that Noah's son, Ham, Shem, Japheth, they go different direction. And it was believed that Shem go to the one side, east side, and that become Asia. You know, Asian people through the Shem. We are, so Asian are descendant of Shem. And also Ham moved to south side from the location, it's south. So if you go from the middle, then it goes to Africa. So Ham descendant becomes the black, all this African or black race, we can say. And another Japheth. Zafer goes to north side, and you know, the middle, if you go from the Middle East, if you go north side, then it goes to Europe country. So all these Europe countries, the Japheth becomes the forefather of the white race, all these European people. Okay. So God confused the language. So what happened? Now they don't understand each other, so they could not build. They couldn't continue to build this building, so they stopped. And now it's, let me read. Then they say to one another, come, let us make bricks and bake them thoroughly. They had brick for stone, and they had asphalt for mortar. So they made bricks, they started making bricks, but they cannot build because they cannot understand. They got confused their language. Maybe somebody asking, bring water, somebody bring hammer, so they cannot continue anymore. Yeah, this is the place still found. Actually, this one, even when Saddam Hussein, I think, I don't know if some of you knows or don't know, Saddam Hussein was a president of Iraq. Yeah. So he tried to build actually this area for the tourist purpose, but God doesn't allow to do that. No. God destroy, which God destroy, God never allow anyone to build. This is the history we can find. Not only this, another many things are. So Saddam Hussein tried to build, but we know he was killed after some years. Okay, and this is the foundation that area. It is now in Iraq. Okay, now we'll talk about Israel. Through the Israel history, we can really know whether the Bible is true word of God or not. If you those who ever know the history of Israel, they cannot really deny the true existence of God and the Bible. Okay, again, same map, world map. Israel is in the middle, and we see India. And why God chose Israel? The Bible has the answer, Isaiah 40. Let me read. You Israel are my witness, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen. So God chose Israelites to be his witness. So when you look Israel, God is, they are witnessing God. When you see Israel, how? Okay, let's see. State of Israel, this is their territory, their geography. And this is their flag. And their territory is 20,425 square kilometers. That's all it. Just if we compare with our northeast, then same as Meghalaya. Little bit in different, in hundreds, not thousand. Okay? So same, we can say same Meghalaya. That means much smaller than Assam also. But now when we look at Israel, the one of the most strongest country in the world, how it can happen? Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 7, let me read. The Lord did not set his love on you nor choose you because you were more in number than any other people, for you were the less of all people. God chose Israelites. It is not that they are very strong, they are very large number, but God chose very few people. Why? Because God can show his power. So that's the reason. So they are witnessing. Purpose of choosing the nation of Israel. One thing is, as witness of God. And number two, and trust them with God's word. Through the Israelites, God gave his word. That is the Bible. All the writer of the Bibles are Jews, except one person. Luke is Gentile. Others are all Jews. And prepare for the coming of the Christ. That's why God chose Israel, because God promised. God needs some group to send his son to forgive all the people of the world. So that's why God chose Israelites for these three reasons. Okay, let's continue. Romans chapter 3 verse 1 2. What advantage then has the Jew, or what is the profit of circumcision? Much in every way, chiefly because to them were committed the oracles of God. Oracles of God means the word of God. So God committed to them, to Jews, God committed his word. And Jesus also come according to prophecy and through Israelites. Because God said to David, God said to Abraham, through your seed, through you, the Messiah will come. So according to that, Jesus born. And this is very important. If we are going to learn Israelites, then Jews people, then we must know this first. Let me read Genesis chapter 12. Because from here, Israel people story begin. Let me read. Now the Lord had said to Abraham, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation, I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. What it says, God called Abraham. Abraham's father is idol worshipper, and during the time of Abraham, it's like a Noah's time, no one is seeking God. But God called Abraham because he wants to show the people that there is true God. So that's why God chose Abraham. And God said, Abraham, come out from your father's house. I will give you land. I will make you a great nation. And you shall be a blessing for everyone. So Abraham was living in Ur, in Chaldeans, but God called and he came out from his father. So God, as he promised, God gave blessing to Abraham. Number one, I will give you land. So he gave Canaan. They were in Canaan. And you will be a great nation. So it becomes Israel after Jacob. Name given Israel. And number three, Jesus was born through the descendant of Abraham. So all these are fulfilled. Now, again, history of Israel. Abraham, one son, Isaac, and Isaac's son, Jacob, and Jacob's name changed into Israel, and Jacob's have 12 sons, and these 12 sons are the tribes of Israel. And after that, they have been through the Jacob's sons. Joseph was sold into Egypt by his brother, and later all areas are famine, and they all family went to Egypt, and they have been there around 430 years. Then through the leadership of Moses, they came out. So that's the history of Israel. Now, through the leadership of Moses, they came out. So what happened? When they came out, after 10 plagues, Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, released them. But later, they chased them and they tried to stop Israelites when they came out. But on the way, there was a river, Red Sea, a huge, the wide is around 19 to 22 kilometers. So there was a river, they could not cross. That time, God divided the Red Sea and they crossed through the dry land. So that is also in the Bible, but many people, this also, they say, people could not believe. How possible? How it can be that big river can be divided into two and can be dry land? How it can be possible? Before God, nothing is impossible. If God cannot do bad things, then He is not worthy to be called God, right? Of course, there are many evidence. So we'll see the evidence whether it is true or not. So Moses and the Red Sea crossing. It is true. Is it true or just fiction or story? So the Exodus, is it real? And has the Red Sea been divided? So this is a common question. Who was the king of Egypt run after Israelites? If all these are true. So even the American meteorologist proved the divided Red Sea scientifically. What did he say? He said like this, 74 kilometer per hour wind blowing for 10 to 12 hours would make it demonstrate in a assume that it can be, the water can be divided. So 74 kilometer per hour continuously wind blows 10 to 12 hours, then water can be divided. And God, who is God? God is greater than all. He created everything. So even you can try, if you take water on the small plate and if you blew it there, then water can be spread. So same thing, sea is nothing before God. God is the one who created even the sea, so He can do, right? So there's nothing not to believe. God can do everything. Of course, there are so many evidence. So what are the evidence? Actually, this is the place they cross the Red Sea. The expert now, after examining, expert says that right, left is very deep, but in the middle it is shallow. So easily they cross that from that place. Okay, here. And also, now, recently, the water, the those who expert in the water, diving in the water, they went inside and they found so many things which Egyptian use, like in those days, like a chariot wheel, all these stuffs they found. Yeah, there are some stuffs which Egyptian they use in the time of Pharaoh. Yeah, these things, these stuffs found. And also, in the story, it mentions that in history, their history, that Egypt, in Egypt, Israelites are slaves. So this is also true. Israelites are slaves for 400 years in Egypt. And now, another questions can be, who is that king? In Egypt, of course, I haven't been there, but some of our seniors, they went, and in Egypt, there's a museum, Cairo, in Cairo, the capital of Egypt, there are 25 mummies. So because Egypt people, they believe that king, they consider king as God, they regard as God. So when king died, they believe that the king will become alive again. So they don't criminate, they don't do anything, just they keep, they preserve, because they believe one day king will be alive. So 25 mummies of the kings of Egypt are kept in museum now. So among the 25, all 24 are same looks, but one is different. All are like this. This is the normal mummies. But one is different. One is like this, full body is salted, and also no ear. Some of the body's flesh are missing, and some eyebrows are missing, some flesh are missing. So now, if they regard king as God, then who can be there to cut the ear of kings, ear of eyebrows, where others are same? Why this is different? So it is believed that this king must be the king who drawn after chasing the Israelites. So this is also under proof. Okay, so the Bible is historically true. archaeologically true. Many are found true. And how Israelites begin? From the Abraham. Because Bible say, in your seed all the nation of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice. Abraham obeyed. That's why God promised that in your seed nations of the earth shall be blessed. So through Jesus Christ all can be blessed now, and Jesus is born even through the Abraham. Matthew, the New Testament begin with this, the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. So Jesus Christ is son of, descendant from Abraham. Okay, so it's time up. So we'll start with the story, history of Israel from tomorrow. Let me finish here. Then let's pray. Let me pray. Mighty Heavenly